Let's make this delicious regular yogurt together from scratch, meaning we are also going to make our starter culture. We don't need a store-bought starter culture or another yogurt to ferment it. Hi, Relish family. Welcome back again to my YouTube channel. I make recipe videos like this once every week. So subscribe to my channel and turn on your post notifications so you don't miss any of our new uploads. Firstly, let's make the starter culture. Add 10 tablespoons of milk into your container and then add in 1 cup of water. Mix this together until it's well combined. Then heat it up on your stovetop till it's lukewarm. If you place your finger into the pot and it doesn't burn you after 5 seconds, then know that your mixture is ready. You can turn this into your container and then slice your lemon into little pieces, okay? Add the sliced lemon into your container. Cover it properly. You can use towels and other clothes to cover it. Store this in a warm place for 18 to 24 hours. I left mine for 24 hours though. After 18 to 24 hours, bring out your culture. Okay, open it. Your culture is ready. All you have to do now is to take out the lemon pieces in the culture. Mix the culture thoroughly and set it aside. Now, let's go over to making the rest of the yogurt. I'm using 350 grams of Milksi dry milk. You can use any other milk brand of your choice. Add 1 liter of water to 350 grams of dry milk. Basically, guys, okay, mix your milk until it's creamy enough for your taste. Sometimes we are so worried about the sizes, the correct measurements, and all of that. When you're mixing dry powder into liquid, don't be too serious about the measurements. Just mix your milk. If you feel that the milk is not creamy enough to your taste, you can add more milk in it. Transfer this into a pot and onto your stovetop. Allow this to heat up gradually on your stovetop until it's lukewarm. So basically, if you can hold your finger into the liquid, like I said before, for 3 to 5 seconds, without it burning you, then you know that the heat is sufficient. Bring it down and turn it into a container. A container that has a very good cover so that it can cover properly. If you're still watching this video until now, please give this video a huge thumbs up. Okay, like and subscribe to my channel. And follow us on our Facebook page as well at Betty's Homestead. Add the starter culture we've made previously into the milk. And then stir very well until the culture gets to every part of the container. Okay, stir it very well. And then cover and allow to sit in a warm place for 12 hours or more. Guys, you can let this sit in a warm place like your oven, okay? Or any other place that you know is warm in your house so that it can retain the heat. And allow this to sit for 12 hours or more. After 12 hours, your yogurt is ready into a different container before mixing it. But I want my yogurt to be watery, okay? I have a different recipe for how to make Greek yogurt, so I'm going to upload that recipe later. I want this particular recipe to be watery so that my kids can just sip it whenever they want to sip it. So you can mix this thoroughly and then add your vanilla flavor and sugar to your desired taste. If you don't want your yogurt to be sweetened, of course, you can skip the sugar part. Mix this together thoroughly and store this in your refrigerator. You can use this whenever you feel like. And the good part is, the longer it stays in your refrigerator, guys, the thicker your yogurt becomes. Like and subscribe to our channel. And follow us on our Facebook page as well at Betty's Homestead. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you guys in my next one.